Hi, welcome to my lecture on Fourier transform of basic signals. So these are basic signal, DC value, impulse signal, exponential signal, signal function, step signal, complex exponential signal, sin omega naught t and cos omega naught t, rectangular function, triangular function, sync function, Gaussian pulse. These all we know in time domain. So in frequency domain, how it will be? Let us start one by one. Let us solve first problem, DC value. X of t equal to a naught. A naught, what is the Fourier transform of a naught? So we know a naught signal, how it will be some DC value t, and this is x of t, and this is zero, some a naught value, DC value. Okay, so if you integrate this one, minus infinity to plus infinity x of t dt, you will get infinity, right? So it is not absolutely integrable. Then you cannot apply Fourier transform for this condition because it is not satisfying Dirichlet condition 3, right? But what we have learned, Dirichlet conditions are sufficient condition but not necessary condition. Still you can solve this one. So I am giving first answer for this, then we solve reverse. Its Fourier transform is 2 pi a naught del of omega. So let me solve reverse. I am using inverse Fourier transform. X of t equal to 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to plus infinity x of j omega e power of j omega t d omega. So here I am keeping this signal so that I should get a naught, right? 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity to plus infinity, here 2 pi a naught del of omega e power of j omega t d omega. This 2 pi get cancelled out. So here x of t equal to, we have minus infinity to plus infinity, here a naught del of omega e power of j omega t d omega. We know formula, this one, minus infinity to plus infinity x of t del of t minus t naught dt equal to x of t naught, right? Here in terms of frequency we have, here omega naught equal to 0, right? This is x of omega, okay? So if you substitute omega naught equal to 0 in this, e power of 0, e power of 0 means 1, right? That is means it is equal to a naught, right? So got it, x of t equal to a naught. So a naught Fourier transform is 2 pi a naught del of omega. For example, if I want for Fourier transform, this one is then 8 pi del of omega. And how its signal will be? So you know t del of omega. Here we have a infinite amplitude and area is 2 pi a naught at 0. See, this signal has a 0 frequency. That's it, right? And area is 2 pi a naught. So it is time domain signal and it is frequency domain signal. So let us see second one. We need Fourier transform of impulse signal. So x of j omega equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of t e power of minus j omega t dt. This is formula, right? So here x of t I am substituting del of t, minus infinity to plus infinity del of t e power of minus j omega t dt. According to this, here t naught is 0. So t naught, if you substitute 0 in this, it is equal to 1, right? So Fourier transform of this one is 1. So what does it mean is, in time domain signal, del of t, if this is in Fourier transform, you will be getting this omega and x of j omega. So each and every frequency required to generate the signal. See here 1, 2, 3 and how much amount required? 1. Let us see third problem. We require Fourier transform of exponential signal. Here 3 problems are there. E power of minus a t u of t, e power of a t u of minus t, e power of minus a mod t. So first one I am taking e power of minus a t u of t signal. So what does it mean? It is e power of minus a t for t greater than 0 and 0 for t less than 0, right? E of t means it is 1 positive values and 0 for t less than 0, right? So if you find Fourier transform on this one, x of g omega equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of t e power of minus j omega t dt. So x of j omega equal to minus infinity to 0, we have a 0 e power of j omega t dt plus, and 0 to plus infinity we have e power of minus a t into e power of minus j omega t dt we have signal. So x of g omega equal to this one is 0 completely. So remaining this integral 0 to plus infinity e power of minus a plus j omega t dt. If you perform integration, what will happen? E power of minus a plus j omega t by a plus j omega, and integration limits 0 to plus infinity. So this is minus, right? If you substitute limits, minus 1 by a plus j omega here, and if you substitute this e power of minus infinity e power of minus 0, right? So this is 1, this is 0. So multiplying with minus 1 means 1 by a plus j omega. So what you got, this one 1 by a plus j omega. Next, so e power of a t e of minus t means it is 0 for t greater than 0 and e power of a t for t less than 0, right? If you apply this formula, x of j omega equal to minus infinity to 0 e power of a t e power of minus j omega t dt. So I am applying Fourier transform of this one formula, plus 0 to plus infinity 0 e power of minus j omega t dt. So this is completely 0. Next, minus infinity to 0 e power of a minus j omega t dt, right? If you integrate this one, e power of a minus j omega by a minus j omega, this is t, our limits are minus infinity to 0. So x of j omega equal to 1 by a minus j omega, this is e power of 0 minus e power of minus infinity, right? So this is 0, this is 1. So 1 by a minus j omega. So what you are getting here? 1 by a minus j omega for Fourier transform of e power of a t u of minus t. Now what about this one? So e power of minus a mod t, this will be e power of for t less than 0, this is a t, right? For t greater than 0, it will be e power of minus a t, right? See, all negative values you substitute, you will get this one. All positive values you substitute, again you will get this one. So we know Fourier transform x of j omega equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity x of t e power of minus j omega t dt, right? So x of j omega equal to minus infinity to 0, we signal how? For negative values, e power of a t e power of minus j omega t dt plus 0 to plus infinity, what we have? E power of minus a t e power of minus j omega t dt, right? So just now we solve this one same. So for this, what we got? 1 by a minus j omega we got it. This one a plus j omega we got it. So if you solve further this one, a plus j omega plus a minus j omega by a square plus omega square, this get cancelled out. So 2a by a square plus omega square, right? So this is 2a by a square plus omega square. So these three formulas you need to remember. E power of minus a t u t Fourier transform is 1 by a plus j omega. E power of minus a t u of minus t Fourier transform is 1 by a minus j omega. E power of minus a mod t is फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म इज 2a बाई ए स्क्वायर प्लस ओमेगा स्क्वायर।